our whole world revolves around hunting season. So it's a new year. It's a new day. It's like my January 1st for most people. This is my New Year's Day. Hope 23-24 season is better than 22-23, better than 21-22. I just want to have a safe year. And everybody have a good time, good weather. Wish everybody the best. Today is August 31st, the day before the opening day of Texas dove season. We are out scouting right now to find out where we're going to hunt. We've got a group of about 65 coming in. We've got several fields that we've shredded. We've got a lot of corn fields that have been cut, some milo fields that have been cut. We're just going to go see where the best number of birds are at. I've got a little bit of shredding that I still have to do on one of our farms. And then we're going to go back to the lodge, and I've got some last minute maintenance items that I need to finish. Look here.
Yep. Why, buddy? Why?
Way down there, way down there.
Oh, yeah, I see those way down there, yeah.
One of our dove properties right here, it's really a neat setup. We got a creek that runs right through the middle of it. Got about four different openings. I've got wheat planted in this field right here, which it don't look like it. I'm not a very good farmer. I shredded the wheat seed and there's some sunflowers in it. This field back over here to the south, I've got hay grazer and milo planted in it. And the field on the south side of the creek, I have sunflowers in. So we really got a good selection of food for the dove. This field right here, I've got sunflowers. I've got hay grazer. On the back side of this field, I've got milo planted. But it's hard to tell right now, but you can see there, you shred that and them sunflower seeds will hit the ground. And them dove love that sunflower seeds. And then I also got this hay grazer, which will make a seed, the top of that hay grazer will. And we'll shred it and it'll knock all that seed down on the ground and give them plenty of food to eat. Got about 75 acres of milo and hay grazer and sunflowers in this field. The field south of the creek, there's 50 acres of all sunflowers.
This place hasn't been open since January. There's a lot of things that somehow opening weekend is a shit show, is just as much as it is fun, but that's part of it. You know, you gotta get those kinks worked out. It's always fun to see Jeff lose his temper on people opening weekend. Like, if there's going to be a blow up out here, it's going to happen on opening weekend of dove season and opening weekend of goose season. It's just the way it is.
It's time! Do you
want to
look at those
scissors?
Do you love the flowers?
I've never been dove hunting anywhere.
They're like, oh shit, they got
moths. You know what?
They got moths.
Now they will. They'll expect it. From now on, they're going to say, we want moths. I like your toenails.
Jesus Christ, we're drinking or working today.
Both.
Got a handle of Tito's.
Having a schedule again, having people to feed, because Jeff doesn't eat anything but crackers and bean dips. So, getting after it again. Kids being out here, the grandkids being out here. Schedule more than anything, and people. But I mean, I love my summer too, don't get me wrong, but what's all the cooler weather, please come on with it.
Thank you.
jalapeno bacon mac and cheese. Put the bacon and the peppers in the broiler for a bit. Kind of crisped them up. I think there's 60 clients. And by the time all of us back here, 70. Actually have nightmares about it for the first few nights. That's not a dream. I was going to the grocery store and everyone was waiting on me to eat for dinner. I had forgotten something. I think it was the trays or something. It's just never ending. Never ending.
Tell the guys, do not park in the fucking grass, and show them where to park, and they park in the fucking grass. They fucking back up halfway down the sidewalk, and back up, they could walk 5 foot in the fucking field. Okay. I tell you what, you tell people where to park and where not to park. I told, what's his name?
The guy in room 9.
The guy in room 9.
I don't know, I told him maybe.
Where to park, I told him where the septic tanks are at. I said,
they went right there.
I don't mind if you pull right up here and park. But don't park on the septic tanks and don't pull up on my grass up there. I'd be damned if I'm down there working on the water line and I come back and they're parked right in the middle of the damn sidewalk, backed up their tailgate down. They don't want to have to walk 5 foot to carry their beer.
What did you say to
him? Didn't say nothing. Just bitching to y'all. Are
you now now he's drinking at 2:30.
You might want to put something up on
2:30 he's drinking. Their truck's going to be in it when that thing falls through.
And I still not heard from fucking Dishnet. I'm going to try to call them cocksuckers one more fucking time.
Why are you cussing so much?
Because we don't have the damn TV over there.
I'll be watching a lot of Long Ranger.
That's your phone, buddy.
Oh. I've been on hold for 7 hours.
Oh, that's so sad.
Yes, it is. And I got to poop, so it's been terrible. So, can you help me?
Yeah, I can definitely help you with your concern. How can I help you for today?
My problem today is that I put my Dishnet on like a timeout. We was going on vacation for a couple of months, and I need it turned back on. It was supposed to be turned on, and it still is not. You're going to charge me for your fucking TV not working? Are you fucking serious?
We want it.
It's going to be on this month's bill. I'll pay my bill, but I ain't paying anything fucking extra. I put the shit on timeout. So I didn't have to cost money, it wasn't supposed to charge me nothing. You kiss my white ass. Say it's a honey.
As normal, the American way, I got a call to a foreign country to try to speak to someone that doesn't speak very good English, and I don't speak very good Bangladesh, and we finally get our TV on $350 later, I guess. So I guess they got the last laugh at me. But there won't be Dishnet up here this year, so they can kiss my ass.
Boss Shot Shells, the evil geniuses. Listen, copper-plated bismuth, you can use your old grandpa's gun that's been sitting on the shelf for all of these years. They do a fantastic job. Customer service is number one to them. You're gonna get your shotgun shells in a timely manner, but you do not need to wait. You gotta get out there. There's gonna be supply chain issues, so go to BossShotShells.com right now. Get everything that you're gonna need. Get that lead out of the environment. It's not good for anything. Boss Shot Shells is always the way to go. I can't really remember how the food challenge came up. I think we were just talking on a podcast, or maybe I'm sure I might have lost a bet somehow. Tex, our preacher, he loves hideous, disgusting food, and it just kind of morphed into this thing to where somehow every food item that I ate and Reese ate, we were somehow saving Jeff's soul.
Then you're gonna be in church tomorrow, starting tomorrow. Continuously for all the items that I eat starting tomorrow.
I thought the bet was if you'd done this, I'd go to church.
No, and then I renegotiated when all this other food got.
Renegotiating means that we both agree on the negotiation.
I didn't agree on all the food. When I first agreed to it, it was one little bitty thing. It was durian fruit. And then somehow we've tacked on pork brains and pig lips and stromboli.
Stromboli.
What's that stuff called?
It's not stromboli's like a
Swedish fish.
Well, it's not Swedish fish either. Strasser, whatever. Okay, I tell you what. For everything you can keep down, and you, if you don't throw up, and you do four items or six items, whatever it is, I will go to church that many Sundays in the next 3 months. Yes, I will.
In the next 3 months? You got to do it in the next 2 months before Goose
Season starts. No, I will handle it over the next 3 months. I will do my church
duties. No, and Christmas doesn't count. Christmas doesn't count.
Okay, I'll give you that.
Thanksgiving doesn't count.
Well, Thanksgiving?
Well, I don't know.
That's not a church holiday. Thanksgiving and Easter don't count.
Well,
Christmas and Easter. I'll do it before
3 months.
I'll do it before the end of the year.
Before the new year.
Before the new year, I'll do every item that you can. But if you throw up, it cancels it all out.
No, it does not.
Yes.
If it goes down my gullet, it's done.
You got to hold it down.
I got to keep it down for how long?
Well, at least.
No.
90 seconds.
I think he has to at least into his mouth,
swallow it.
Rick. Attempt to swallow it.
If I can swallow it, it should count.
If you hold it down for 90 seconds, then yes.
If it goes down,
15
period.
Seconds.
If it goes
down, it's got to be some seconds.
If it goes down, period.
If you hold it down for 30 seconds.
15.
Okay,
15.
Now hold on a second, because I feel like I'm missing something here.
What are you missing?
I need Tex out here as my.
I have a feeling this is going to be so horrible that might not be.
Okay, how many items seconds? Are there?
I think there's four or six. I don't know.
And for every item that I eat and hold down for 15 seconds.
I go to church for one time.
One Sunday per item.
Yes.
In the next 3 months.
Yes,
before
sir.
The new year.
Yes.
And Christmas does not
yes,
count.
I agree with you.
What other holidays are there?
I'll do it. No, yes, we'll do it. That's fair.
Interest and pride in Scottish and Celtic history is evidenced by the large attendance of Scottish, Irish, and Celtic festivals across the U.S. Americans of Celtic ancestry are one of the largest ethnic groups. Since 1996, they've been making this crap.
That says heated up.
Microwave on high power for 5 minutes.
He said just eat it. He says this ain't gonna make no difference.
Put that sucker up.
Here.
Hospital's only, 5 minutes away?
I don't think we're gonna die.
Look at the cans, damn it.
It's been on the shelf a while. Nobody wants this crap.
Oh boy, that looks like dog food.
Got mold on the top.
I don't think that's right. I don't think that's good.
Oh yeah, it's good.
I think that's, no, I think that's turned.
That smells like cow poop.
Yeah, it's good for you. All right.
I've seen dog food look better.
God, oh my, oh.
You want to play, or are you just going to be a savage?
Yes.
Well, we're not. Listen, this it's a one-bite challenge is all that it is.
Are you ready?
No. Those aren't maggots.
Same.
Cheers.
Ooh, God, I can smell it.
Is it good?
Tastes like Alpo.
Not tastes bad. Like Alpo.
It's like dried chili meat.
I've that's had Alpo bad. In a can before, and that's exactly what it tastes like.
You've had Alpo in a can before? He could take him another bite and see.
Go on, try a bite.
It's not bad. It tastes kind of like
really
chili.
Not bad.
Tastes like chili.
It tastes like chili.
The deal is,
that's one Sunday.
He's got to go to church on Sunday, and he has to hug the people.
No, we didn't say nothing about no hugging.
We can go back on the tape. It was go to church and.
No, there was no hugging.
Nope. You got the tape.
Me and Andy have to deal. I have to do all these. I told him if you do everything, I'll go to church 6 weeks.
Hold on. No,
before
no, no.
The first of the year.
No, you said a year.
No, but now listen. Reese just did one, so that's two Sundays.
Yeah,
so
but Haggis didn't count.
Nope. Yes, it does too. You're up to three. Reese, you have to sit down right here.
I'm already trying to Welsh out.
He's at three Sundays because I ate it, Reese ate it. Everything that Reese eats is two Sundays.
This is the one you're worried about?
Yeah, mudfish and rice.
Fermented mudfish and rice. Where is this from? I can't even pronounce that. Pampanga?
Pampanga. Pampanga, product of the Philippines.
Oh, one of my best friends was Filipino. This won't be nothing. That's gonna be tough. That one's gonna be tough.
Oh, gosh. Oh. Oh.
Hope that doesn't sound like that coming out.
Oh, gosh. Young mudfish.
Young.
Treat yourself to exotic taste. Prepared from fresh young mudfish and precisely fermented to achieve perfect sourness.
Perfect sourness.
Traditionally served with fish
and it's and FDA vegetable. Registration.
Oh, so it's safe. We're good.
It's safe because FDA said it is.
If you eat the whole can, the judge has to go for a year.
Woo, boy, this one is.
Get that off to get you a big bug.
No, back up.
Ready? My God.
What's it taste like? What's it taste like?
Blue cheese.
That's going to be hard to swallow.
What's it taste like?
Like blue cheese.
What's blue cheese taste like?
Blue cheese, mustard, salt, and something sour.
Thought you were good at this.
Wow.
Don't throw up on me. Throw up that way.
Need to throw up. That was just hard to get down.
Bad, isn't it?
Come on, Reese.
You're going to try it? It's for Judge's soul. That's big enough. That's big enough. That's big enough.
Is that an extra Sunday at Reese's?
Two extra Sundays.
Jesse, we don't need you chirping in.
Reese loves salad.
He laughs.
It's not bad.
It's not.
Mind over matter, kid. Golly. If you don't mind, it don't matter. Pork brains and milk gravy. Is this one FDA approved?
Lots of people in the South eat those in their eggs, the scrambled eggs.
Oh, I bet that's what that is. U.S. inspected and passed by Department of Agriculture. So we're good.
What's fun is it?
Oh, I taste that.
Reach on camera.
All right. Oh, this is a new larger size. We're in luck.
Yeah, you're supposed to eat a can apiece of this, each one of you.
No, I don't think so. When you take the can, just look. Ooh.
Ooh, it looks good.
That's the milk gravy. Know. Might need a bowl for this one.
Yeah. No, you just don't. Oh, yeah. Good, yeah.
Look at Zachary. Zach's like,
Zach picked up
bricks. Cat throw up.
That looks like puke.
Just pork brains. Be good on eggs.
It would be good with eggs, but after eating that mudfish.
It tastes pretty good, huh?
Ah. That went for two. So that would after be
you want to try a bite?
Sit down and have your bite.
You have to sit down. On your butt. Here you go.
Do it for the memories.
He's not doing as bad as I thought he was, huh?
We watched the challenge a lot. It prepared him.
I watched the NFL too, Jesse. That'll make me.
Not bad. Pickled pig lips. This will be nothing.
Shouldn't be.
You eat these all the time, right?
Nah.
Pig feet?
I didn't even know there's such a thing as pig lips.
Ooh. Ooh.
Doesn't smell like anything.
It just smell like a little bit of pickling is all that it'll all it'll smell
yeah,
like.
Yeah, it just smells like vinegar.
The burps are not good.
Mine just tastes like coconut.
Oh, they didn't take the whiskers off of it.
Oh gosh. Oh man.
I figured they'd take the whiskers
oh,
off.
Be like kissing my grandmother goodnight. She'd come in late at night, kiss you, she had whiskers on her lips. It's the same kind of whiskers.
Okay. I'm not really sure how to attack this one.
I think you just gotta eat it with your hand.
Dig in. Ooh. Ooh, I wish I hadn't done it like that.
The roots go deep with those whiskers.
It's horrible.
The roots go deep with those whiskers.
I mean, just smash it.
Trust me, you want the. Okay, there you go.
Oh, smells good.
Tastes like pickle.
Tastes good. It just tastes like salt.
That is a weird texture.
Yeah. Tastes like foam.
A little bit like foam.
All right, now the grand finale.
because it's fermenting. Oh, God help me.
My stomach hurts.
Oh, it's bubbling. It's bubble. Oh! It's shot. It's shooting.
Is it bubbling?
Yes. It's definitely shooting back at us.
Drink the juice.
No,
eat the chili. The chili's the one that isn't bad.
This is a delicacy in Sweden.
What's the name of it?
Stromboli something.
Sir Stromming. Sir Strom. Holy crap.
Sir Stromming.
Texas is about to blow.
We're attracting flies. We got to hurry.
Flies would be good compared to this.
Can you smell it? Oh my. Throw up.
Oh, goodness.
That's bad.
Decided this one. I thought it was going to be whole fillets. It's just a bunch of
crap.
There's not a single fillet in there. Look at that crap.
This is a delicacy.
I think you said everything's a delicacy.
Good. God, it stinks.
Rick said he's not eating this.
Oh, I
gosh. Oh, my God.
What is it? What's it taste like?
How you gonna get?
Oh, I spit. Oh, I spit.
That's bad.
What's it taste like?
Bad. Sit it out.
Do it, Reese. Do it.
That's bad, bad.
Reese, come on, show your cup for the rest of
2 weeks, baby. 2 weeks.
Wow. There's a lot of cheese in that.
Tex is always the king at his workplace, but what's that?
Got it.
Oh, yeah.
God almighty, that was a good match.
You're going to try it? Well, that's tiny enough.
And just chew it up and swallow like it's chocolate candy. I'm not going to like you anymore.
Sour.
It's just sour.
You're
sour. I can't smell it.
Oh, I mean, you're eating it next to that, so. So I think we've actually got a little bit going to our advantage because that's frozen.
I always just want to say I eat it.
Oh, let's see.
It's good.
Tastes like pickled buttholes.
Not bad.
It's actually pretty good. Y'all probably get in on this.
That's two.
Here go, Rich.
Smells good.
Eat it. It's kind of like the cacao that we had.
You like it, Jeff.
I tasted it. What I tasted mingo was not bad.
Go hand it to your mom.
Try it, Mom.
It's kind of like the cacao with the a little slimy.
It's not.
I wonder if it'd be
that good. Sir Stromming was bad.
I wonder if it'd be thawed out all the way if it was bad.
Ooh, that's bad. All right, well, eating challenge is done.
Now Judge has to go for 1 year.
Judge has to go for...
A year.
No.
4 Sundays.
One Sunday for me and 2 Sundays for everything Reese ate.
Oh, cool.
So he'll be a regular.
Reese held it together too. Like he went for seconds on several things. I don't know if he thought that would double Jeff's time in the Lord's sanctuary and really cleanse his blood, really get bathed in the blood. But Reese held it together well. Tex kind of lost it at the end though. He disappointed me because he's the nasty food connoisseur. I am not. I got a very weak stomach.
Didn't have a lot of drama this year at all with the hunting at all. But other than the TV situation with the dish net, everything else was pretty smooth. We had a really good that I can remember. I don't remember a lot of problems with dove season at all this year. We didn't play as much cornhole as we normally do. My teammate Harry died, so I didn't really have a teammate, so I didn't do as much of that kind of stuff. But dove season overall was pretty well in here. I mean, we were busy, and the hunting was really good. We had a really good dove season.
Our new Blackstone, we're gonna start doing some vegetables in the evenings. Okra, stuff like that. Got my utensils, gonna put them on my little hangers right there. That way I look professional. And look at there, the damn button's missing. What a bitch. What happens when you buy the floor model? Oh, here we go. Let's do this number right here. Rookie move, I gotta turn the gas on.